reminds us to say, brother, this is wrong. You say, hey, look at yourself. Who are you? Who do you think you are? Allahu Akbar. I had one youngster tell me, even my father doesn't tell me that. Allahu Akbar. Well, bring him, we'll tell him as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our doors. Just as well you told me he doesn't say it, now we know that he also needs a bit of advice. May Allah make us parents who are role models for our own children. Amen. Wallahi, that's a powerful dua. May Allah make us parents who are the role models of our own children. Amen. Allahu Akbar. So they told him, you are just a human being like us. وَمَا نَرَاكَ اتَّبَعَكَ and look at those who are following you, look at them. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ هُمْ أَرَانِنُنَا بَادِيَ الرَّأِي. They are the worst from amongst us. They've got no material standing at all. Nobody respects them in society. They are foolish. They haven't even thought before they followed you. They don't even know what's about to come in their direction. As though they are threatening to boycott these people. Imagine. So who followed? Those who were downtrodden. And this is why when Abu Sufyan radiallahu anhu, before he was a Muslim, he had gone to Hercules, the Romans. And Hercules asked him a question, Hiraql, about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, what type of people are following him? The rich or the poor? He said, well, most of his followers are the poor. He says, well, that is all the messengers. It has happened to them. Quite similar. Look, Hercules is confirming that those who are downtrodden and not so wealthy, they are quicker to accept the truth than those who are high and those who are wealthy. Allahu Akbar. We are fortunate, we are Muslimin. We hope and pray that the more we get in terms of wealth, the more down to earth we are. The quicker we surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command. May Allah open our doors of goodness. May He grant us pure sustenance that brings us closer to Him, and not sustenance that will drive us further away. People normally say that this man was a good man. Now that he's seen money, he's changed. I usually say, no, money doesn't change you. All it does, it gives you now the opportunity to show the true colors of who you always were. Because if you had bad qualities, they were hidden. When you have a boss, you need to say, yes, okay. He says, be here at 8. No, 5 to 8. You say, okay. But the day you got more money than him, you say, what? 5 to 8? You're mad. I'm going to come at 11. Allahu Akbar. May Allah open our doors. Because now you know you have a standing. So it only gave you the opportunity to show your true colors. Those who were good prior to wealth, they are still good even after they've got that wealth. May Allah keep us in that way. So this was the excuse. They said, we see these people are all weak. وَمَا نَرَى لَكُمْ عَلَيْنَا مِنْ فَضْلٍ بَلْ نَظُنُّكُمْ كَاذِبِينَ. We don't see any virtue for you over us. In fact, we consider you liars. You are a liar. What virtue do you have over us? You're just like us. You've got eyes and ears and hands and everything just like us. You are a human being. There's no virtue. This was the excuse of the people of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of that in Surah Hud. And this is why He told His people, Ya qawmi, أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِن كُنتُ عَلَى بَيْنَةٍ مِّن رَبِّي. Oh my people, listen very carefully. What if Allah has granted me signs, clear proof, clear evidence? Are you going to consider it?
وَآتَانِي رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِهِ فَعُمِّيَتْ عَلَيْكُمْ.
And what if Allah has given me mercy and has had mercy upon me, which you are blinded from? You cannot see. What do we learn from this? Allahu Akbar. Sometimes because of our evil deeds, we become blinded to the right, straight path. This is why I mentioned the other day that one of the greatest acts of worship is tawbah. To ask Allah's forgiveness, to search in your life where you are going astray and wrong, and to constantly ask Allah's forgiveness. Because when you ask Allah's forgiveness, there is now hope that you will see the light. You know, one day there was a brother who told me regarding a certain problem. He says, at least now there's light at the end of the tunnel. I said, brother, they haven't yet seen the tunnel. Forget about the light. Allahu Akbar. May Allah open our doors. Really, sometimes people haven't even seen the tunnel. Once we get to the tunnel, then there'll be light at the end, inshallah. But if you haven't seen the tunnel, where? We'll probably head to the oceans. Allahu Akbar. May Allah open our doors. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam that he says, what if Allah's mercy is blocked from you? What if Allah's mercy is blocked from you? You need to open your eyes and see what I'm saying. Turn to Allah. So his people continued to argue. They argued again with him. What did they say? وَيَا قَوْمِ In fact, he said again to his people, one more point. وَيَا قَوْمِ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ مَالًا إِنْ أَجْرِيَ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ Oh my people, I'm not going to ask any recompense from you. I don't want money for what I am teaching you. I don't want any wealth for what I am teaching you. And from this we learn straight point. Whenever there are those calling us towards goodness, the spiritual leaders, if they fall under the employ of someone, they are less effective than those who do not fall under the employ of someone. That is a general rule. Unless they've been given authority, which is very rare, you find that they are always tapered down by those who pay them. And this is why Nuh alayhi salam made it very clear, I not only don't get a salary from you, but I don't want it. I'm not asking you for a penny or a cent. My reward is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why he could say whatever he wanted to. He uttered it, the truth. He didn't mind. And he knew he had the assistance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they told him, okay, we're ready to accept. They had a private meeting. They said, we're ready to accept on condition that you see those who have followed you, they're all paupers. We're going to come and sit with those paupers and everybody's going to look at us and say, look, the top and the bottom, they are now mixing. That's not going to happen. So get rid of them. Tell them that you guys, you move out. We got some more important people who are coming to accept the guidance. Now the same was uttered by the kuffar of Quraysh to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And here he is being told that happened from the time of Nuh. So what did Nuh alayhi salatu wa sallam say?
وَمَا أَنَا بِطَارِدِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا
I am never going to chase those who have believed. I can't chase them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows their level. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows their condition. I am not going to chase them at all. He says,
وَيَا قَوْمِ مَنْ يَنْصُرُنِي مِنَ اللَّهِ إِنْ طَرَدْتُهُمْ أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ
Oh my people, if I chase them away, who is going to help me when Allah's wrath and anger descends on me? Who is going to assist me against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if I chase away the believers? Allahu Akbar. And there are other beautiful verses in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of what Nuh alayhi salam said. He said, these people appear to be low in terms of worldly standings, but you don't know their hearts. You don't know their hearts. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This is why sometimes we feel the piety in those who are poor, very, very poor. Sometimes we see people, and I have witnessed people in some of the most remote areas of Africa. We entered one area, very, very remote area at the time of Asr. And we were looking for Muslims. And we were going through, literally having parked the motor vehicle in one corner, one side, and we were walking through the bush. And we noticed there was a field with a lot of plantation on it. Maize was planted and it was quite high, the height of a man. And as we walked through it thinking that now there's no one, it was the time of Asr. We heard, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدًا And there were at least 200-300 people reading Salah and they had all come up. And where were they? Where were we? Wallahi, I had to weep when I'd seen that. And I told myself, these are the awliyaullah. These are the friends of Allah. For water, they go to the river, which is 5 kilometers away with buckets, but they're happy. Come time for Asr, nobody is there to tell them, hey, Salah. And you find all of them quietly on the ground, no musalla, no nothing. On the ground, Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. You know the sight. I felt like I was such a weak Muslim, looking at these people who have endured so much and they are happily worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where are we? It reminded me immediately of a verse that I need to share with you. Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala,
Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu man yartadda minkum an deenih fasawfa ya'ti Allahu biqawm yuhibbuhum wa yuhibbunah.
Allahu Akbar. Oh you who believe. If whosoever is going to turn away from this deen, then remember Allah will bring other people whom He will love and they will love Him even more. Allahu Akbar. So let's not turn away. When we don't read Salah, there are 10 other people who are reading Salah. Recently, in many countries, there are women who have removed their hijab because of the pressure of the globe. So by removing the hijab, I normally say, my dear sister, if you have removed it, there are 10 others somewhere else who have donned it. So it's not Allah's loss, it's your loss. For every person who thinks they have now removed the cover or removed the dress code that Allah has ordained, Allah says, don't worry, we flick you off. Do you know what? We'll show you on the day of judgment. As a result, there were 10 others who donned it. Allahu Akbar. You want to miss your salah? There are 10 other people in the remote regions of Vietnam who will start their salah. But we don't know. Our minds are too small. We don't understand and realize. So Nuh alayhi salam said, these people, they are pious. Allah knows their heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the condition of their hearts. I'm not going to chase them away in order to facilitate for you and for you to come. Another thing, if he had chased them away and these people did come, that was one condition. Sometime later they would have made another condition and a third condition. So a person who wants to attack you on one front, don't think that he's not going to attack you from all the other fronts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. Remember, these stories are mentioned in the Quran for us to derive lesson from. It was not needed to make mention of the previous stories. So much so that in this story of Nuh, when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was mentioning this story to the kuffar of Quraysh and to the Muslimin, do you know what? They doubted. They said, no, this man is speaking things which are fabricated. So Allah says in the Quran, whilst in the midst of the story of Nuh alayhi salam, أَمْ يَقُولُونَ افْتَرَى. Are they saying that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has fabricated this? They don't know.
قُلْ إِنْ افْتَرَيْتُهُ فَعَلَيَّ إِجْرَامِي وَأَنَا بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُجْرِمُونَ.
O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, if I have fabricated this, I'm going to get the sin of it. And I'm not going to hold the sin of what you people are doing. So weigh what I'm saying. This is an example. It is a story of a previous nation confirmed by revelation without a speck of doubt. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam in Surah Al-Shu'ara as well.
قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُ لَكَ وَاتَّبَعَكَ الْأَرْضَلُونَ قَالَ وَمَا عِلْمِي بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ إِنْ حِسَابُهُمْ إِلَّا عَلَى رَبِّي لَوْ تَشْعُرُونَ وَمَا أَنَا بِطَارِدِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِنْ أَنَا إِلَّا نَذِيرٌ مُّبِينٌ.
He had a response for everything they said. He had a response for everything they said. Allah makes mention of it here. They say, should we believe in you when all these useless people have accepted your message? There is a difference between us and them. Kick them out. He says, oh my people, I don't know their hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows their deeds and their hearts. How can I block goodness from them solely because they don't have much materially? Allahu Akbar. I am a warner. I will warn clearly. And this warning will come. Now they got upset. They were upset. They started, for how many years did this last? Not 10 years, not 100 years, not 200 years, not 300 years, no, more. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says.
وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فَلَبِثَ فِيهِمْ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ إِلَّا خَمْسِينَ عَامًا.
And we sent Nuh, Noah, may peace be upon him,